So they say you can manage information in the app, but the problem is they decide what you see or not. If you create a program, most of the developers say, hey, it's my program. I can decide what you see or not. And the same apply here. They may say, hey, you can manage your own information, but that's not true. They can decide what you see or not. Let me give you an example. If you send a message, and in the message is a link, third parties can see where you are from, where you're coming from. Or when you press a link, they can see your IP code and they know exactly where you are. So changing your mobile phone number, yeah. Deleting your WhatsApp account, you may delete your WhatsApp account at any time, including, yeah. So this is how you can manage the information. You can delete your account, change your phone number, or change your setting. Only those four options. So those are the only four options that you have. Okay, let's see. I have a dream, that's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief. Privacy policy, that's the interesting part. Okay, if you live in Europe, you need to follow these terms of services, but also the privacy policy. Respect for our privacy, including, it's the code in our DNA. Yeah, this is BS. Because they talk about privacy, but they don't care about that. Because if you look at the things that they offer companies in order to make ads, they do not respect your privacy. For example, check Facebook business where you can create ads. You will see there how much information they gather, and you have to see it like this. That's only on the Facebook product, but the Facebook product is connected with the WhatsApp product. How do I know that? If you create a Facebook page, you can connect your Facebook business page with your Facebook page. And it's connected, and they can share information with each other. So they have information about your user. So they have information about you. So WhatsApp provides message, internet calling, and other service to use around the world. Our privacy policy helps explain our information practice. The thing is, it helps explain, but doesn't mean that's real, because people can, some things can, it happen like that, but people can give a twist to that situation. They may say, hey, we do not collect information, while they are doing that. But sometimes they can say, that's lying when they say that. We do not collect information, they collect information, then they lie. But sometimes they can say, we do collect information, but only with your permission. But they're saying, we collect information. But they're not saying what kind of information. So they're technically not lying. And that's what you see a lot in these terms. Because if you look at the terms of Signal, or if you look at the terms of Telegram, you will see that it's really simple. They are clear. And if you look at these terms, you'll be like, okay, what are they doing? It's a little bit complicated. How does this work? That's the question you're going to ask yourself. So, and every time you talk about respect for your privacy is code in our DNA, it's a slogan that every company that they are using just to promote that they respect your privacy. I mean, not be the case. Thing is, most of the people are used to WhatsApp, so they are used to, okay, WhatsApp, I chat with a friend, so I'm not going to change unless all my friends does that. Some of them don't care about their privacy, so they just keep using it. There's nothing wrong with that. But at the end of the day, you will see in a couple of years how valuable your privacy will be, because company have information about you and it can work against you. So we joined Facebook in 2014. Okay, this is interesting. Since we started WhatsApp, we have built our service with a set of strong privacy principles in mind. In our up-to-date terms of service, you find information that is easy to understand, or updated terms of privacy are easy to understand and reflective. This is not easy to understand. A normal person cannot read it no more, because you need to understand the whole purposes, how the system works. Okay, let's see. We joined Facebook in 2014. WhatsApp is now part of the Facebook family. Yeah, that's what the terms that they use. WhatsApp is part of Facebook family. If you're part of family, you share information with your family. That's technically what they're doing here. and they're saying privacy is in our DNA. Think about that. Our privacy policy explains how we work together to improve our services and offering. So technically, we are giving you something for free, but you need to give us information, data about yourself, so we can sell your ads. That's what they're saying here. Like fighting spam across apps, making production search in, showing relevant offer and ads on Facebook. You see? So if you have WhatsApp and you connect with Facebook, if you talk with someone about certain kind of topic, you can see some ads on Facebook. They say on WhatsApp there's no ads, but in the future there will be some ads because WhatsApp is not profitable for Facebook right now. Because I cannot see their business model yet. Including your message, photos, account information will be shared on Facebook or any other family apps. Honestly, nothing you post will be shared on WhatsApp for others to see. So technically, all your information, they're saying lately, will be shared on Facebook. Do you want that? Did you get permission? Imagine you are a person that only use WhatsApp and your information still will be shared on Facebook. And in the future, there will be some company that they contact you to sell you some products, because in the past, you looked those products up. Understand what I mean? Then we have, your message are yours. We cannot read them. We have built privacy. Okay. Interesting. They're saying no third-party banner. We will not allow third-party banners ads on WhatsApp. I see. But WhatsApp business, people can still send you, business can still send you messenger. Because that's something that they are trying to sell you, a product they're trying to sell to business in order to make it profitable. And new ways to use WhatsApp, we will explore ways for you and your business to communicate with each other using WhatsApp, such as an order, transaction, appointment information, deliver shipping. Wow, privacy is in our DNA. In order to use all these things, you need data. Example, you need to know where someone lives. You need to know someone's payment information, otherwise they cannot pay. Appointment, you need to know what's if someone is available on that date or not. So these are all datas. And if you share it on WhatsApp, they're saying use the user, nobody can see. Business the user, they can see. So, and they can also share the information with each other. So technically, all those business sharing those information together on that platform. The choice you have, if you are an existing user, you can choose not to have your WhatsApp information shared with Facebook to improve your Facebook ads. Ah, you can choose. Wow. It's something you can choose. So they say you can choose to share your information with Facebook or not. And it's up to you. You can do that at the account setting. Most time it's difficult to do it for a lot of people. Most of the time people do not know how to do it. So technically it's an opt-in and you need to opt out. So hopefully you understand what I mean. So you come in and when you connect it to Facebook, you share Facebook information. And if you do not connect, you don't have certain kind of features in WhatsApp. Understandable. Information we collect, information you provide, your message. We do not retain your message in ordinary course of providing services to you. Once your message, including chat, are delivered, they are deleted from our service. So technically, they will be on the service and then they will be deleted after a while. But Facebook has it, but they are saying we cannot read your message, right? So what is this? It's a little bit confusing. A front saying, hey, we cannot read your message, but saying, hey, your message is for 30 days on our services. It's a little bit weird. I'm not saying I'm an expert in understanding how it works, but if you are putting certain kind of things into words, just be real with people, just like Signal and all stuff. Why does it have to be on your service for 30 days? That's also something curious, and 30 days, a lot of things can happen. So technically they're saying, hey, we cannot read your message, but they're saying, hey, your message is on the services. Interesting. Your connection, to help you organize how you communicate with others, we may create a favorite list of contacts of you and create it. So technically, they are collecting also data here. Do they have permission? Customer support. You may provide us information. Yeah, that's understandable. Use it and lock information. Yeah. So technically, every time you log in or if you use WhatsApp, they collect those kind of data. You may think, oh, that's not relevant right now. But imagine if someone knows when you go for visit website, or someone can predict it, and someone can predict it when you log into WhatsApp, when you're using WhatsApp, and that can be helpful information when they send you later ads through WhatsApp if they introduce it. They're saying we're not going to provide show ads on WhatsApp, but you never know what will happen in the future. And by collecting data already, they are making preparation for in the future. Transactional information, device and connection information. These are all data. Cookies, also data. Status information. And third-party information, third-party providers, third-party services. Yeah. So they can get information from third parties, providers. They can also give third-party information about you. But most of the time you need they need to have permission to do that, and I didn't see that here. Let's read it. We work with third-party providers to help us operate, provide, improve, understand, customize, support, and market our services. For example, we work with companies. Yeah, I can understand that. But these providers may provide us information about you. Wow. So technically they're working together with Apple. And they can get information about you. Let's say you buy something in WhatsApp with the Apple payment. They get some information about you. They're not saying what they do with the information. They're not saying that they delete the information afterwards, but they have it here, or that they are required by law to keep this information. You do not find it in here. So they're collecting a lot of information about you. Third-party services. We allow you to use services in a connection with third-party services. If you use our service with third-party services, we may receive information about you from them. Yeah. Okay. Interesting. So technically, they're talking here about how we collect information. Okay. How we use information. That's what they're talking about here. We use all the information we have to help us operate, provide. Okay. Yeah. Services. We operate and provide our services including, yeah, safety and security, communication about the services. You see here, they're saying to optimize the services. Yeah, it can be true, but they are not saying what kind of information they're using. You don't see that here. Safety and security. The thing is, what kind of information are you collecting for the safety and security? That's also something you don't know. Communication about services. Yeah, I can understand when you have a question or if you want support, they need some information about you. No third parties. We do not allow third party banners ads on WhatsApp. We have no intention to introduce them, but if we ever do, we will update this policy. So you see? In the future, there will be ads on WhatsApp because WhatsApp doesn't have a proper business model right now. So that's something. Commercial messaging. We will allow you and third parties like business to communicate with each other using WhatsApp, such as through our transaction, appointment information, delivery, and shipping. So technically, you're using WhatsApp to communicate with each other, but Facebook has all those information. So this is saying how they share information. You see, this is not clear what kind of information they are using and what kind of information they are sharing. That's not clear. So if you look at the terms of Signal of Telegram, you see that they are really clear about what kind of information they are using and how they are using it. But if you see here, a lot of broad things. And it's hard to say, okay, they're using it for this and they're using it for that. It's hard to say here, seriously. So benefit of the doubt? No. No benefit of the doubt for WhatsApp. I wouldn't use it. I stopped using it a couple of months ago, so I'm not using it. So let's see. Information you and we share. You share your information as you use the communication through our service, and we share your information to help us operate. Yeah, they use this as a general way of saying we use the information to help make our offer and services better. But the offers and services, the services are using the service of WhatsApp, right? But there are other companies that need to have some profile about you in order to make ads better. And as soon as you connect with Facebook, they're offering you the offer of other companies, because they need to sell ads in order to provide the funds in order to keep WhatsApp alive. Hopefully you understand what I mean. Account information. So your phone number, profile name, photo, online status, status messenger, last seen. Yeah. So these are the information we share, third party providers. And here, this is also really weird, third party, weird. When you use third party services that are integrated with our service, they may receive information. Wow. So they may receive information. Technically, they receive information such as Google Cloud. You need the number, email address. Yeah, there's something they do that. Affiliate company. Yeah, so they join the Facebook family company. So technically, they are sharing those information with the Facebook family, and those things are sharing information with other companies with ads. Do you want that? So this is the big downside of WhatsApp. WhatsApp may be the first one messages app, but since it's went to Facebook, a lot of things goes wrong. And I don't think people should use WhatsApp if they value their privacy. If they don't, use WhatsApp. Don't worry about that. But if you value your privacy and the information that you share, let's go to Signal or Telegram. I think those things will become better with the future, but WhatsApp and Facebook, no go. Same apply for Instagram. Instagram may seem it's okay, but the more you use it, the more you see that people get addicted to Instagram. They keep scrolling. And the same for Facebook. And most of the time you see they're wasting a lot of time on those things. So yeah, when you belong to the Facebook family companies, a lot of those things will happen, because people will be like, Facebook will be like, hey, I want you to spend as much time as possible on my platform. And that's why people use a lot of time Facebook, Instagram, and WhatsApp, and they stay there. And most of the time they see ads. Sometimes they buy the things, sometimes they don't, but you will get addicted. Try to use other stuff. Let's see, what do we have here? Assignment, change, and control, and transfer. Yeah, it's really not interesting, but you can read it. Managing your information, something important. If you like to manage, change, limit, and delete your information, we allow you through the following tools. So they're saying you can manage information in the app, but the problem is they decide what you see or not. If you create a program, most of the developers say, hey, it's my program, I can decide what you see or not. And the same apply here. They may say, hey, you can manage your own information, but that's not true. Yeah. They can decide what you see or not. Let me give you an example. If you send a message, and in the message is the link, third parties can see where you're from, where you're coming from. Or when you press a link, they can see your IP code and they know exactly where you are. So changing your mobile phone number, yeah. Deleting your WhatsApp account, you may delete your WhatsApp account at any time, including, yeah. So this is how you can manage the information. You can delete your account, change your phone number, or change your setting. Only those four options. So those are the only four options that you have. Okay, let's see. Law and protection. We may use, preserve, and share your information. Yeah, so that's technically by law they will need to share your information. Let me ask yourself a question. You say we cannot read encrypted messenger, but if the law is asking you to read it, you can read it. But what happens if the law doesn't ask you about it? Will you still read it in order to help you improve your ads better for your customers? Only when the law requires that you need to share it with the law. But you're saying, hey, we cannot read your message. it's a little bit creepy. So they're saying we cannot read your message, but when the law asks it, we can read it. Weird, right? And we need to give you the benefit of the doubt. Creepy shit. People know what to say in certain kind of legal documents, but when you look at the reality, most of the time it's not correct. So our global operation. You agree to our information practice, including the collection, use, share of your information, describe as in policy. So technically, your information will go to the United States. It will be shared with Facebook. And you're gonna do anything about it. That's what they say. Global operation. That's what they say here. And here they're saying you can update it. And here you can contact them. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, if you look at this is an interesting, really bored privacy policy. Because if I were a person and I need to give WhatsApp the benefits of a doubt, I wouldn't do that. Because if you look at this, the terms of condition of privacy policy, there are a lot of things in it where you, when they're saying that they're doing certain kind of things, but when you read in depth, you will see how can you do that while you're saying this here. And they're keeping a lot of things secret. I can understand that you don't want to expose those things, but most of the thing is evident because they belong to the Facebook family. It's evident for them to share all this information with this company. Otherwise, how they are going to get money? Because Facebook rely a lot on those ads and revenue. Facebook may do other things to get some revenue, but at the end of the day, it's all about the ads and all about the customer that they're having. So if they show ads on Facebook, you will see most of the time if it's connected on WhatsApp, you will get to see all those ads. And now they're saying, okay, you know what? We are not going to put some ads into WhatsApp, but on the long run, we may change this, but then we will update this privacy policy. They can collect information right now. Let's say 5 years of information, of 10 years of information, is a lot of information that you can use for the rest for like 10 years, because you make certain kind of profile, you can predict what people are doing or not. That's technically what they're doing. They're experimenting and what works and what doesn't work, and then apply it. And when they're sure of the case, they're gonna put some ads into WhatsApp, and then you have to pay for it to delete those ads. Do you want that? The same happened with YouTube. YouTube started first without ads. Now they have ads. You need to pay for it in order to delete those ads. Do you want that? So, safe bet. Start now. Convince your people, your friends, family to go to Signal or Telegram or whatever. You can start because there are other providers out there, and they look like WhatsApp. And when you look at them, what they're doing with ads, you'll be like, okay, they're going way too far with privacy. Because the company doesn't do anything. I'm not going to put names in it, otherwise I need to discuss it in another video. I'm not sure I'm going to do that because the legal documents of those company are in different language, and I do not know if I can get an English version of those things. So is WhatsApp going towards that situation? You never know, because now there's law it's preventing it, but in the future you never know. But that doesn't mean behind the scenes they are not doing that. So you may provide certain kind of information through WhatsApp. It doesn't mean they are not using this data. They are saying they're not using this data, but they are. I have a dream, that's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief. Know what I want, so I'll take it on. I've made mistakes, but mistakes make you strong. Let's break it down for a minute. I want the crown, I'm gon' get it. You hear me loud, man, I'm winning. Yeah, Charlie Sheen will be